Yeehaw! It's time for the SketchUp AI Roundup.
That's right, it's the AI Roundup, the AI Rundown, AI Recap, the AI bulleted list of all the AI tools that are implemented within SketchUp now. A little aside for you, the video up top, AI, right? Probably couldn't tell, but the dead giveaway, the hat. I don't own a hat like that. But I guess if you do, if you have an old one and you don't need it anymore, let me know. I'll give you my full home address and then you can ship it on my way. Just kidding. I'm not going to do that. But let's just get right into the video. All right, here we are at the AI Roundup. And we're going to start with the most obvious tools that use AI within SketchUp, and that is the tools that have AI in the name. So if I click this AI pixie dust sparkle, what would you consider this? It's in the top right here on desktop, on iPad and web. It's kind of towards the top left bar, SketchUp AI. And these two tools are the first we're going to talk about. So AI Assistant and AI Render. Let's start up with Assistant here. And the help portion of AI Assistant is a help chatbot that uses ChatGPT 4.0 and a RAG, or Retrieval Augmented Generation, on the SketchUp Help Center to pull down information that is the most up-to-date and accurate for any help you need with SketchUp. So let's see, I got the camera where I like it here, but I can't remember exactly. And so I can ask it here, how do I save a camera view? Scenes, yes, very good. Okay, go to the scenes panel, click the add scene button. What does the add scene button look like? Plus sign icon. Oh, well, that makes sense. So you can use conversational questions here and it will search and bring back responses that are accurate to what's on the help center. And the cool thing about this too is it works in any language that the help center is localized in, which is 12 different languages. So if you want to try looking up questions in your own language, there's a good chance that it will return responses to you in a way you can understand, which is cool. The other part of AI Assistant that is cool and uses AI is generate object. So generate object can create 3D objects from files or prompts. I'll go for a prompt this time. So this uses an AI model called Rodin to generate the objects. Here, let me just start something off real quick. This is gonna be leather beanbag chair, generate. And it generates an image that you can then select and generate in 3D object from. If I don't like this particular one, I can say generate more images. And a few different options here. Most of them look pretty similar. We'll say use this image. You can add additional prompt if you want. I like the look of this leather. One thing to note too is that this is going to use credits. Credits are associated with your account and they refresh every month. And there is an option to get an additional subscription for more credits if you use yours up and you don't want to wait for it to renew. I'll generate this model and skip forward. And here it is, I'll click download. And it generates the, apologies for my 3D mouse lack of skills, but it generates the geometry itself and then also textures that have photoreal materials applied, or photoreal attributes, I should say, as I get this into place here. Pop back to my scene, and it actually looks a little too shiny, so let's head in here and change the roughness down. Oh, it's got metalness turned all the way up too. That could be part of our problem here. Yeah, that looks a little more comfy. Okay, very good. And then the other part of the AI taskbar over here, the AI toolbar, is AI render. AI render uses a number of different models to create images from. When you go to the different preset prompts, auto is a prompt that uses Flux Kontext, which gives pretty good results. These other exterior photorealistic, interior photorealistic, on down the line, use Juggernaut 13, which is a stable diffusion model. And let's just try out the auto. See how the automatic does for us here. You can add an additional information in your prompt if you'd like. But I'll just click generate. And again, this credits icon means it's going to cost me 5 credits. I'm okay with that. And for your sake, I will again speed this up. Gives you a couple different options to pick from here. So for the most part, I like what this gave me, except for what's going on outside the windows here, which I can use the inpainting tools for. And this uses SDXL, which is a stable diffusion model, to do the inpainting. So I'll go to the settings here and I'll switch this over to lasso. And then I will lasso the window. Add that part in there. And I'll say photoreal trees outside the window. And hit enter and wait for that to generate. Again, a few different options. This one gives a little better look at what's going on as opposed to this. So I appreciate that. I'm not going to go over all the tools that are in AI Render, but we have other videos for that. But this gives you a pretty good overview of what AI tools are in the AI Render extension. I'll add this to a new scene as an overlay, and I can switch back and forth between my model and my render, my AI render here. Next up in the AI tools, I have this model, which the client mostly appreciated, except for the roof. They wanted to have a metal roof, and this is not it. They have a dark metal roof in mind, and they sent me an image of the type of material that they would like to have on the roof, so I will apply this here. And while it looks okay, it's also a little flat and not exactly tiling as I would hope. As you can see, there's kind of an extra bit here that's not exactly tiling appropriately. So the next AI tool is, when you go to edit this material, you can see, as I zoom in over here, this, again, we see our AI sparkle. Use AI to generate photoreal textures, which will make this seamlessly tiling texture to remove these bands that you can see here. And it will also generate the relevant PBR texture maps. So let's click this and give it a second to do its work. All right, so here it is. It is particularly shiny. So definitely metal. I think it needs to be more rough, though. I'll also bring up the normals to give it some kind of depth. And I'm going to adjust the position to give it a more realistic scale here. All right, looking good. Now that we have our PBR properties onto that texture, it looks a lot better than the flat version. And I'll switch these other panels to the updated scale as well. And now we're at a place where the client is a lot more happy with how that roof looks because it's exactly what they're looking for. And one last note from the client on this is how we're going to talk about the next AI tool, which is 3D Warehouse Image Search. 3D Warehouse Image Search. So if I go down to this bench, the client didn't like this bench. They have a very specific bench in mind that looks like this. They want this kind of bench. Okay, let's see if it's on the 3D warehouse with a 3D warehouse image search, because I don't really know what search terms to use to get to that. So I'll drop by 3D warehouse. I can either drag and drop an image in here, or I'll just go ahead and search. And let's see. I think this one looks very close. Enrique G, thank you for your work, because this is the perfect bench that I'm looking for. I'll just replace it in here. And everybody's happy because we use 3D Warehouse Image Search to find the exact right model we were looking for based on the image. AI powered. And for the next two AI features, we're gonna switch over to iPad. Okay, the first AI feature in SketchUp on iPad is part of scan to design. So I'm not actually gonna scan this, but this is my basement as I orbit around here. And the AI part of scan to design in the automatic tagging situation. So when I go down to canvas scan, and this is under tags and meshes, you can see that it artificial intelligently, can identify what is furniture, what are seats, what are tables, and what is part of the room, meaning if I want to have the ceiling on, if I want to have the floors off, or the walls gone. So all these, even though these different items are in different groups, they're also on different tags, and that organization was done through the use of artificial intelligence, or as we like to call it, AI. And as I go to a new file here, the other item that uses AI is auto shape. So auto shape lets you draw, hey, that's a nice looking hand right there. Wait, that's my hand. See that? Anyways, there are a number of different shapes you can draw that will, with auto shape, that will be identified. So if I can draw, oh boy, it'll take my rough drawing here, identify what it is, and then bring in a live component that is associated with that auto shape gesture, I suppose you could call it. So let's do another one. I always forget what these are, so I have to go back to the guide here and see what they are. Oh, here, sphere. Let's see if I can draw a nice sphere. Oh boy, nope, but maybe the AI can tell me, oh yeah, it knows right away that's a sphere. And there it is. And we'll do one more. How about an awning window? I think I could draw that. And there it is. And again, these are live components, so I can go in and change the information here, change the parameters in order to change the component. And these were all made using auto shape powered by AI in SketchUp. All right, so a pretty varied list of tools in there, I think. Have you used any of those tools? Have you had good results? Have you had not so good results? Let us know in the comments. And also, if you've seen another AI tool out there that you think would be cool to be implemented within SketchUp for your workflow, let us know that as well. We always are looking for the latest and greatest in making your life easier, your work easier. So let us know that for sure. Hey, like and subscribe, and have a great day.
Yeehaw!